Hey guys, welcome back to my channel.
Kanika Jain this side, and in this video, we shall be talking about the 7 different ways to use floral oriental paper from Dress My Craft. So let's get started. So here I have these beautiful flowers which I made out of the floral oriental paper and Dress My Craft dies. Here's another one which I created using the floral oriental paper. Here is the card onto which I did stenciling using the Dress My Craft stencils. Here I use the distress inks to create this beautiful background. And onto this card I used embossing folder to give a very worn out and old look, and I then ripped the paper to give this effect. So all these projects are made using the Dress My Craft floral oriental paper. Even the card base, this one, is the floral oriental paper. So I would like to call it a magic paper, and with this one paper you can create beauties. So now let's get into the video and know more about this floral oriental collection. So this is the Dress My Craft floral oriental collection. This is a set of 10 sheets.
It is premium white cardstock in the size 12 by 12 inches, and it is 285 GSM paper. Also, these are acid lignin free, as well as these are eco-friendly papers.
Now let me show you how the paper looks like. Here you can already see that I have done some die cutting, and using the daisy die I have made this flower. Also, this paper is so versatile that you can do so many things, so make sure you watch the video till the end to know what all can be done using these papers. Another amazing quality of this paper is that it is non-fibrous, so whenever you dip it in water or work with water, you won't get any fibers coming out of this. Here you can see I used the floral oriental paper and did some distressing on the background, and as well as splattered some water to give a very nice background, and you can see how beautiful this has come out to be. Another amazing technique which I want to show on camera is the paper smoothing technique, which is done using any of the ink. So today I am going to make a card as well as a tag. So here I am using the Dress My Craft paper trimmer and just trimming off the paper to the size what I want, and then here I am using this rectangular tag punch from Dress My Craft and punching it out to give the tag shape. So the base which I am using is the floral oriental paper. So first of all, I will be showing up the tag with the help of distress oxide inks, and then I will be showing the card with the help of distress inks. So here I am just showing the blending first. That here you can see how amazingly the paper is picking up the color and how amazingly it has blended very well. Now I'll be blending in two colors. The first one was fossilized amber, and now this one is the picked raspberry. The paper picks up the inks very well, leaving no marks behind or no stains, you can say. Also, if you're enjoying this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel, and the link to all the craft supplies used in this video is mentioned in the description box. And here you can see how beautifully the colors have blended in very well, and I just love the effect. Now let's move on to the card base. Here I am using different color distress inks, that is Abundant Coral, Candied Apple and Wild Honey. So here I am using the non-stick craft mat, thick one from Dress My Craft, and adding my inks to it. And now I am just misting some water, and then I am picking up my floral oriental paper and then misting water onto this, and then picking up the colors. And here you can see how beautiful the outcome has come out. I just loved it. It's amazing technique to give the watercolor base. So here I am done with the first layer. I just want to layer up my background. So here I am just drying the inks. Here you can see how beautiful it looks. Now again I am going to pick up the color, the leftover color, to give some more layering to the base. And here you can see how amazingly the paper has responded to the inks and how beautiful the background is coming out to be. As it is a 285 GSM paper, so it is very sturdy, and you can do a lot of techniques with this paper. So here you can see how quick and easy was it to create your own watercolored effect background with the floral oriental paper. Another technique is that you can die cut. So here I have these swirls die from Dress My Craft and I did some die cutting. So you can use your floral oriental paper for your die cutting as well. You can die cut directly the white as it is paper, or you can create your own backgrounds and do some die cutting like this. Here I am using the ultimate die cleaning tool as it helps me to take out my die cuts easily. So you can say another use of this amazing paper is to do die cutting. Now moving on to the next thing is that you can create these beautiful flowers out of the floral oriental paper. So here's another flower which I created. So with the help of just one Dress My Craft die, I created three different types of flowers. So here I have these pre-die cuts from the Dress My Craft daisy flower and I have colored them as well. And I have die cut them on floral oriental paper. Here I am using our embossing foam pad as well as the groove golf tools. Here I am taking a bowl filled with water and I am going to dip these flower petals onto this and then I am going to remove the excess water with the help of the paper tissue. You can dip these petals for around 5 to 10 seconds. Just make sure the inks you are using are permanent and non-water reactive. This will make our flower petals a little bit soft and easier for us to work on. But when they will get dried, they will be absolutely like before and even more harder. So now with the help of my groove golf tools, I will be giving shape to these flower petals. If you want to know more about these groove golf tools, make sure to watch our previous video. The link to the same is in description box, so you can check that out. These petals now are semi-wet, so you can let them dry naturally or also you can heat set it. While you're heat setting it, you will see and notice that your paper shrinks a little bit and becomes more harder than before.
And in this flower, for the flower center, I use the flower pearls from Dress My Craft. I use the golden ones. So if you want to know more about the flower pearls, make sure you check out our previous videos. We have uploaded them. So this one is the 3D flower and this has the flat base. So you can see the type of variations you can make using the Dress My Craft floral oriental paper as well as the flower dies which Dress My Craft has.
So with the help of this magic paper, you can create beauties in a lot of projects. So I'm looking forward to see your recreations and your creations with these floral oriental paper collection. So do share your creations with us. We would love to see them. See you until next time. Happy crafting.